Hey guys, in this video we're going to talk about how you can install Ardour on Linux. This is an open source program that you can download for free, but if you want the installer, you have to pay for it. Instead, we'll go over how you can download all the dependencies, compile, and install the program absolutely free. To start off, we'll want to download all the dependencies. These are required for the program to compile and install. The first step is to open the terminal. You can do this by pressing Ctrl, Alt, and T all at the same time. You can install all the dependencies by typing each line below in the video description into the terminal and pressing Enter, or you can run a script that we've posted in the link below. Keep in mind that while the script is faster, you will need to change the file permissions and it's a little more advanced. For this video, we'll use the script to make it quicker, but if you want to individually run all these commands, it will work exactly the same. You'll see at this point we have the option of selecting real-time mode for Jack, which is one of our dependencies. We'll leave this off for now and come back to it later on. To get the installation to continue, use the arrow keys to make sure no is highlighted and press the Enter key to continue. The next step is to install Git. This is a program we use to download all the source code to a folder that we'll compile it in. To do this, type in sudo apt-get install git. Now that Git is installed, we'll want to download all the source code for the program. First, we'll create a new directory to keep this in and we'll call it Ardour. To do this, type in mkdir Ardour into the terminal and press Enter. We now want to change directories so we're in that folder. Type in cd Ardour to switch to that folder. Now that we're in that folder, we can download the source code. In the terminal, type in git followed by this URL, which is in the video description. The program will now begin to download to the selected folder. The source code for the program is now downloaded to our folder. This has created another Ardour subfolder within it, which we need to switch to. Once again, type in cd Ardour to switch to this folder. Now that we have all the dependencies installed and the source code downloaded to our computer, we can begin the process of compiling the program. The first step to this is configuration. This will check that all the dependencies are met and that the system is capable of compiling the program. We launch the configuration by typing /wafconfigure in the terminal. Keep in mind that you still need to be in the folder that the code is in. Looks like our configuration is complete and the program is ready to compile. This process can take quite some time to complete. When we ran it on our system, it took about 20 minutes, but your results may be different depending on how fast your computer is. We've sped up the process for this video. To start off by compiling, type in /waf. Our program has now finished compiling, but it isn't installed. This next step isn't completely necessary, but it makes it easier to launch the program. To install, type sudo /waf install into the terminal. If you forget to type sudo and don't run it as a root, there will be an issue with permissions and the program will not install. Now Ardour has been completely installed on our computer. There's one more step to take care of before we start the program. We need to run Jack and turn off real-time mode. Though we selected to have this off earlier, it doesn't always work properly in the installation process and we need to have it off, otherwise it won't run and will cause issues with Ardour. Open this by typing qjackctl into the terminal. From here, click on Setup and turn off real-time mode. Now we can press the Start button. You won't need to turn off real-time mode every time you run the program, but you will need to run qjackctl from the terminal and start it. Finally, we can launch the program. Open a terminal once again by pressing Ctrl, Alt, T, and type in Ardour 5. We'll run through the first time setup and create a blank project to start the program. Just follow the on-screen instructions all the way through and the program will start. We're going to turn off real-time monitoring mode since we're using our audio interface. Now we'll create a new project called Test. We'll leave it in the default folder, but you can change this to whatever you wish on your own system. Looks like the program is completely installed and working properly. At this point, you can use the program absolutely free for as long as you want. Thanks for watching this video on compiling and installing Ardour on Ubuntu Linux. If you learned something or found this video helpful, you can give us a like and subscribe to the channel. If you want to keep up to date on all our new content, you can like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Links to our social media accounts can be found in the video description.